Hey everyone, it's JJ from Filmora, here to empower your inner video creator, and we are back with another episode of You Ask, We Answer, our series where we answer the questions that you guys leave us in the comment section of our videos. Yep, we're back. Alright, so before I get started, I just wanted to mention, if you didn't already know, the launch of Film Socks, the next evolution to the effects store. Film Socks has the Filmora video effects you already know and love, with even more resources like stock footage, music, photos, all royalty free. So if you haven't already checked it out, be sure to do so at www.filmstocks.com. And if you guys have any questions about Film Socks, go ahead and check out our FAQ video up here. Thank you guys so much for all of your questions, as well as your patience. We know that some of you have been experiencing some crashes with Filmora 9, and our team is working really hard to work on the bugs that you guys have reported. So if you haven't done so already, make sure you guys are using the latest version update, which is 9.1, which you can get at the website description box below. All right, so make sure you update. Let's get started. So I have the questions in our lovely backpack, and we're gonna answer them at random. All right. So our first question comes from Dopely. Can you link two tracks together in Filmora? For example, a video and audio track, so if you cut it, it cuts on both. All right, so you can't link them together, but if you want to cut both an audio and video track, you can. So let me show you how to do it in Filmora. With your video clip in the timeline, make sure that there isn't a specific track selected. You can tell because the track will be highlighted on the left side of the timeline. Place your playhead at the place you want to make a cut and click the cut button. This will cut all the tracks. See? Both audio and video. Did it. There it is. Right, let's get into our next question. So, our next question comes from Michael Studio Films. So how do I jump cut? All right, so we released a video on creative ways that you can create jump cuts. However, we didn't really show you how to do it. So I'm gonna show you how to do it right now. So a jump cut is when you cut a section from the middle of a clip and looks like you have jumped forward in time. So to make a jump cut, play your clip on the timeline and pause at the spot you want to cut. You can also use the arrow keys to scrub through the timeline to find the spot you want to cut. Use the scissor icon to make the cut and delete the portion you want to remove from your clip, or use the ripple delete option by clicking shift and delete. To use jump cuts creatively, like making a cup appear, scrub the timeline to the part where you want the cup to appear. So this would be when I snap my fingers. Cut the clip and replace it with me holding the cup. For this trick to work, the subject should be in the same place in both clips for a smooth jump cut trick. Play it back, and boom. A cup appears. All right, so the next question comes from Coklat Keiju. What kind of camera do you use? Great question. So, this camera, which one is it? So this camera is the A7 S2, and this camera right here is the A7 R2. Right? Yeah. Both Sony. Question. All right, so this question comes from Officially Lydia's Life. In Filmora 9, how do we make our PIP shaped though? All right, so let me show you how to do that in Filmora 9. If you go to the utility folder under the effects category, drag the image mark feature onto your PIP clip. Double click on the PIP and find the image mask under the video effects section in the editing options. And it'll be able to choose the shape and adjust the size and position. So there you go, that's how you basically create a mask in Filmora 9. All right. Okay. So, what else we got in here? This question comes from Brighton McCriddle. How do you clone yourself in Filmora 9? So cloning can be done with the camera and a mask feature in Filmora 9. So let me show you how you can do it. Let's go. With your camera on your tripod, first you'll need to film yourself in two different scenarios. Next, bring the footage into Filmora 9 and place the footage in separate video tracks with the footage of your main subject on the bottom track. Next, go to the utility folder under the effects category and drag the image mark feature onto your clone clips. Double click on the clips and find the image mask under the video effects section in the editing options. Choose the last shape and adjust the size and position so that the main subject can see through the mask. And there you go, you've just created a clone. Super cool, right? Super, super cool. Although I don't really know what the world would be like if there was multiple JJs. Well, anyways, let's get to the next question. So this question comes from PD Chi. When is the redner button coming? Really, really need it. Yes, all right. So the render button is going to be coming and will be released in the next big version update, which will be 9.2. So this update will include split screens, time lapse, and even a shared media library. Pretty cool. So this update is estimated to be released by the end of summer, so stay tuned for that. But yes, exciting news, the render button and split screen are coming back, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you guys next time because you know what? I want to see you here. So make sure to subscribe, right? Because we're friends. We're friends, right? Okay, bye. Bye.